conference about to start.
Just click that.
WYOT radio.
Press conference about to start.
Okay, hold on.
Mute them, so you can just hear. Okay. Good afternoon. My name is Jeff Herman, J-E-F-F-H-E-R-M-A-N, with law firm Herman, Mermelstein, and Horowitz. And I'm here today to announce the filing of a lawsuit against a website called blackplanet.com, their parent companies, as well as against a couple individuals by the guy name of Emerson Callum and Levon Flanders. Callum also goes by the pseudonym jah-t. The allegations in this case are really, really disturbing. According to my client, as alleged in this lawsuit, she had become a member of blackplanet.com and posted some modeling photos of herself. She was contacted by a woman, she believed to be a woman, who claimed to be a talent scout. This woman offered her an audition in South Florida for a Bacardi commercial. My client, thinking it's a woman, and began to trust this woman and gave her her phone number so she could be contacted for the commercial. Eventually, my client came to South Florida and went what she thought was a rehearsal for an audition. She was given 3 shots of alcohol to drink. Unbeknownst to her, the alcohol was laced with alcohol, was laced with drugs, we believe with Xanax or some sort of combination of a date rape drug. And once drugged, my client was raped and videotaped during the rape. She was not even aware that this happened because the drug had blocked her memories. About a year later, she received a phone call from her real agent, who asked her why she was doing porn movies. And of course, this was shocking to my client, not even aware that this had happened. And unfortunately, my client, what had happened was she was videotaped while she was being raped. The rape video was made into a movie film, a DVD that was being distributed called Miami's Nastiest Nymphos, and there's a numbered series of them. This apparently was going on with not just my client, but these two men did this to numerous women. They've both been indicted now by the U.S. Attorney's Office, and we have a copy of that indictment for you to see there. But part of this lawsuit, of course, it's against these two men, but it's also against blackplanet.com. And what we allege essentially is that blackplanet.com, like a lot of these social networking sites, act as sort of a virtual bar. And that we allege that they knew or should have known that there were men going onto these websites who were really predators, disguising who they were to gain the trust of innocent young women, where they then would commit these horrible acts. And so just like a bar, if it had knowledge or should have knowledge that this was happening to women in their bar, we're alleging that blackplanet.com also has liability for failing to warn my client and other women about the dangers of what was really happening on these websites. It's a large website. There's over 15 million users. Blackplanet.com it's sort of like a Facebook for the black community. It's been around for a while. It's owned by a large media company. And so that lawsuit was filed. And my client, who was going by Jane Doe, is on the phone. And she was going to make a brief statement about how this has impacted her. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay. If you can go ahead and just kind of share with us how this has been for you.
This has been very hard on my life, mentally, emotionally, and very devastated when I found out about it. I was on the brink of a suicidal emotional breakdown. I thought that my life was over. I was degraded. It was very embarrassing to me because at the time, people wouldn't come up to me about it. This is something that I have had to live with without getting any help for a very long time. My justification is that we deserve justice, the women that have been attacked and harmed by these men. We deserve justice for what they did to us. And I would just like for the other women to know that they're not alone, that they're not the only victims. And sometimes we feel alone because for the longest I've felt very alone and very hurt. And what they did to us was horrible and sick.
Okay. We'll go ahead and take some questions.
Can you ask, Jeff, because this was the question a lot of people have. So when you're under this drug, you can black out and still be conscious, correct?
Yeah, did you understand that question?
You can black out and still be conscious?
I mean, yes. you are not completely unconscious when you look at the video, but you have no memory of what had happened.
Well, after, getting older, supposedly the drug, depending on how much they give you, can affect your memories. You can lose, I've lost a lot of memory from things that I knew before, I was drugged. Depending on how much they give you, it can affect you in the long term as well.
But in this case, did you remember it? Did you know it happened?
No, I did not. Not until I saw the video. Until I was confronted about the tape, I had no idea that I had sex with this person. I had no idea who he was. I had not given him permission to have sexual intercourse with me. And I had never been able to know that he had sex with me because I didn't even know who he was or what he looked like.
What went through your mind when you saw that video?
I got sick. I threw up. I was mental. I was devastated. It was horrible. I was so disgusted, and what they did was so degrading. It's just beyond.
Yeah, it really is beyond human decency. It's so dark. And what these men did to just my client and other women, it's just, it doesn't get any darker. I mean, really, really, really disgusting acts.
There were other women.
Yeah, there are a lot of other women who also had come forward, and the U.S. attorney has indicted these men based on these some of these other women's allegations.
What about the production company and the companies that are selling this video?
Right.
About to start.
Just put that.
WYOD radio.
Press conference about to start.
Okay, hold on.
Mute them. So you can just hear. Okay. Good afternoon. My name is Jeff Herman, J-E-F-F-H-E-R-M-A-N, with law firm Herman, Mermelstein, and Horowitz. And I'm here today to announce the filing of a lawsuit against a website called blackplanet.com, their parent companies, as well as against a couple individuals by the guy name of Emerson Callum and LaVon Flanders. Callum also goes by the pseudonym jah-t. The allegations in this case are really, really disturbing. According to my client, as alleged in this lawsuit, she had become a member of blackplanet.com and posted some modeling photos of herself. She was contacted by a woman, she believed to be a woman, who claimed to be a talent scout. This woman offered her an audition. Just put that.
WYOD radio.
Press conference about to start.
Okay, hold on.
Mute them. So you can just hear. Okay. Good afternoon. My name is Jeff Herman, J-E-F-F-H-E-R-M-A-N, with law firm Herman, Mermelstein, and Horowitz. And I'm here today to announce the filing of a lawsuit against a website called blackplanet.com, their parent companies, as well as against a couple individuals by the guy name of Emerson Callum and LaVon Flanders. Callum also goes by the pseudonym jah-t. The allegations in this case are really, really disturbing. According to my client, as alleged in this lawsuit, she had become a member of blackplanet.com and posted some modeling photos of herself. She was contacted by a woman, she believed to be a woman, who claimed to be a talent scout. This woman offered her an audition in South Florida for a Bacardi commercial. My client, thinking it's a woman, and began to trust this woman and gave her her phone number so she could be contacted for the commercial. Eventually, my client came to South Florida and went what she thought was a rehearsal for an audition. She was given 3 shots of alcohol to drink, unbeknownst to her, the alcohol was laced with alcohol, was laced with drugs, we believe with Xanax or some sort of combination of a date rape drug. And once drugged, my client was raped and videotaped during the rape. She was not even aware that this happened because the drug had blocked her memories. About a year later, she received a phone call from her real agent who asked her why she was doing porn movies. And of course, this was shocking to my client, not even aware that this had happened. And unfortunately, my client, what had happened was she was videotaped while she was being raped. The video was made into a movie, a DVD that was being distributed called Miami's Nastiest Nymphos. And there's a numbered series of them. This apparently was going on with not just my client, but these two men did this to numerous women. They've both been indicted now by the U.S. Attorney's Office, and we have a copy of that indictment for you to see there. But part of this lawsuit, of course, it's against these two men, but it's also against BlackPlanet.com. And what we allege essentially is that BlackPlanet.com, like a lot of these social networking sites, act as sort of a virtual bar. And that we allege that they knew or should have known that there were men going onto these websites who were really predators, disguising who they were to gain the trust of innocent young women, where they then would commit these horrible acts. And so just like a bar, if it had knowledge or should have knowledge that this was happening to women in their bar, we're alleging that BlackPlanet.com also has liability for failing to warn my client and other women about the dangers of what was really happening on these websites. It's a large website. There's over 15 million users. BlackPlanet.com it's sort of like a Facebook for the black community. It's been around for a while. It's owned by a large media company. And so that lawsuit was filed. My client, who was going by Jane Doe, is on the phone. And she was going to make a brief statement about how this has impacted her. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay. If you can go ahead and just kind of share with us how this has been for you.
This has been very hard on my life, mentally, emotionally, and very devastated when I found out about it. I was on the brink of a suicidal emotional breakdown. I thought that my life was over. I was degraded. It was very embarrassing to me because at the time, people wouldn't come up to me about it. This is something that I have had to live with without getting any help for a very long time. My justification is that we deserve justice, the women that have been attacked and harmed by these men. We deserve justice for what they did to us. And I would just like for the other women to know that they're not alone, that they're not the only victims. And sometimes we feel alone because for the longest I felt very alone and very hurt. And what they did to us was horrible and sick.
Okay. We'll go ahead and take some questions.
Can you ask her, Jeff, because this was the question a lot of people have. So when you're under this drug, you can black out and still be conscious, correct?
Yeah. Did you understand that question?
You can black out and still be conscious?
I mean, yes. You are not completely unconscious when you look at the video, but you have no memory of what had happened.
Well, after, you know, getting older, supposedly the drug, it, depending on how much they give you, can affect your memories. You can lose, I've lost a lot of memory from things that I knew before, you know, I was drugged. Depending on how much they give you, it can affect you in the long term as well.
But in this case, did you remember it? Did you know it happened?
No, I did not. Not until I saw the video. Until I was confronted about tape. I had no idea that I had sex with this person. I had no idea who he was. I had not given him permission to have sexual intercourse with me, and I would never been able to Now that he had 6 weeks, I didn't even know who he was or what he looked like.
What went through your mind when you saw that video?
I got sick. I threw up. I was mentally, I was devastated. It was horrible. I was so disgusted, and what they did was so degrading. It's just beyond.
Yeah, it really is beyond human decency. It's so dark. And what these men did to just my client and other women, it's just, it doesn't get any darker. I mean, really, really, really disgusting acts.
There were other women? Yeah,
there are a lot of other women who also had come forward, and the U.S. attorney has indicted these men based on these some of these other women's allegations.
What about the production company and the companies that are selling this video?
Right, well, we've named them as defendants. One of them is Miami Vibes Enterprises. There is a company that's still selling the video, believe it or not, that we've named as a defendant called Dcash Technologies, and DSYNTERNET Online, and Disernet Media. So we've named them, and we certainly intend to stop the distribution of these videos.
How is it legal to continue to sell this video without her consent?
It's a good question. I don't know. And that's for the criminal authorities. But as we're attorney in a civil case, we're suing to try to put an end to that.
Are they saying there is a release then?
The men?
Yeah. No, the companies who are selling the video.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know what they're alleging. I mean, they drugged these women. They may have had them sign things when they were drugged. It's if they did sign anything, it's certainly not a valid release.
They may have had them sign stuff when they were
drugged. I've heard from the authorities that in every the cases were different. I don't know that. I'm not aware of my client ever signing anything, but once they drugged these women, they were compliant, and I'm not sure what they had them do in terms of those things.
What should Black Planet have done, and how should it have done?
Well, what it is, it's we're alleging it's a failure to warn, and that actually, if you go on the site now, there are warnings that didn't exist when this happened, and so certainly those warnings should have been there. But I think they need to go further. I still don't think there's sufficient warnings. We believe that when you become a member of a site, there should be something that immediately comes to your attention that you have to, that you're forced to see. And also, when it's too easy for these men to pretend they're women going on and becoming members and using the website, in this case, blackplanet.com, to further this scam, this fraud. And so, there needs to be some checks and balances. I think on one hand, they're these social networking sites want to generate more numbers, and they're aggressively out there marketing themselves, but they need to grow more slowly so they can be safer.
So just to be clear, the two men, the website, and all of those production companies are being sued for a total of $10 million altogether?
Well, ultimately, we say the damages exceed $10 million. Ultimately, a jury will have to kind of sort that out. And that's for the jury to decide. But yeah, we've sued all those defendants.
Are you asking the jury to decide something novel in this case?
Yes, I think it is. I think this is a novel case. I think the law exists to bring the case under just general theories of negligence. But I do believe this is the first case against a social networking site alleging these sorts of claims of negligence.
Wasn't this site sort of renowned as a place for young women to post their modeling pictures and to attract some attention?
Exactly.
And I guess the question is how much naivete can a client of this website bring to the site? I mean, is she allowed to go just totally innocently into this website and post this stuff with no understanding of the times that we live in, the nature of the internet, and the presence of predators just about everywhere?
Right. Well, we do allege that they're the websites marketing themselves and encouraging women to go ahead and further their careers by posting sites. And what she posted was totally appropriate photos. She'd never done anything like this. She'd done normal, typical modeling stuff. And so, she did what they encouraged her to do. I don't think she's any more naive than or innocent than all the other women on there. And the difference is that a website who's in this business has the aggregate knowledge as what's going on in the website, has more information than one individual has. They know of these things, and or they should have known of these things, and that's the difference.
Jeff, I have to ask this question, but I think it's at the crux of the story of your client. For those who watch this story and say, you know what, I don't believe her, how would she respond to people like that?
Well, I'm not sure what they don't believe. I mean, this has happened.
They don't believe that she had no memory and you know.
Well, I'll answer that question. Okay. I mean, the science is there, and this is what happens with these date rape drugs. And unfortunately, they are readily available today. In this case, we believe the Xanax, which is very easy to get. And anyone who spends a little time trying to figure this stuff out, who's in that mindset, knows how to make a concoction. And what it does, and the experts have told me, that what it does is it prevents your brain receptors from absorbing the memories, basically. So you're basically conscious and participating and you're compliant because you're so drugged, but your mind will not store those memories. So you can't necessarily access those memories after the event. It's like when you go into surgery, there's many anesthetics they give you, similar thing, where you're up during the surgery, but you will not remember what had happened during the surgery. And this isn't a one-time case. There are a number of girls who this exact same thing happened to. I heard from another young woman this morning who was on a different website. Same thing happened. She was also put on a video. And she also had no memory of what had happened until someone saw her pictures and told her about it. And I will tell you that the reason she's come forward now is because she saw the bravery of my client here. She had been suffering in silence, had not gotten help all these years. And when she saw that someone else was coming forward, she decided to come forward herself. And so.
So this is a situation where if anybody was watching this video, they would never know the woman in the video was drugged.
Oh, I think you can tell they're drugged.
You can tell?
I mean, if you look close, they're on her eyes.
Out,
no, not
visibly,
she's,
something is not right.
To me, it looks like they're certainly drugged. But if you're watching the video, you may not. I mean, they're compliant. They're drugged, but they're compliant, meaning that they're not unconscious.
For several parts of the video, I am dead limp.
Yeah, there are parts of the video where she's sort of passed out, and you can see that. It's very disturbing.
Does she remember coming to Miami?
Yeah, she remembers coming to Miami. She remembers meeting the man and getting in the car to go on this audition. She remembers the stuff before the, you know, where she's drinking the shots. You know, what he did is he told her, you're going to walk into a bar and order, say you're going to order a shot of Bacardi Gold. He says, I'll be the bartender, I'll serve it to you. So she would do that, he'd pour a shot, she'd drink it, and then he'd say, okay, change this up or give her some coaching, she thought, in anticipation of the real audition. She did that a few times, and then basically doesn't remember anything until she's back home.
Why did she go back that second time?
She had no idea it happened. She thought she just didn't get the part because she didn't handle her alcohol so well. And so she actually tried contacting them first a couple days later after the first audition saying, did I get the part? And they told her, and then they contacted her and said, no, you didn't get the part, but there's something else that we have for you. You know, which is just, you know, for her now in hindsight, you know, it's very difficult to, she asked herself that question, you know, why did I go back? But the truth is she didn't know.
Have these men been found guilty?
They were just indicted by the U.S. Attorney's Office last month.
Okay.
Yeah.
They've been served, everybody's been served in this lawsuit.
I don't know if they've been served, we just filed it yesterday.
So.
So
you don't know if they're in custody yet?
They're in custody, I believe, yeah. They were indicted
last Friday, where there was a superseding indictment on the case that we checked yesterday.
Will this change the way the internet works if you prevail in this lawsuit?
I hope so.
How's it?
Well, I hope that these companies are much more proactive about policing themselves, about accountability, about warnings. There's so much more they can do, I believe, than they're doing. And it's a matter of, yeah, maybe they're not going to grow as fast. Maybe the profits will be lower. But it will be safer. And for example, and this is an aside from this case, but there's no reason that all the national databases on predators and the state predator lists aren't cross-referenced with emails and et cetera when people are registering. become members online. If you just knock out a small percentage of people on that, you're saving lives. For these kinds of things, there has to be accountability. You should have to prove that you're a woman with a driver's license or some sort of verification. It's too easy. It was too easy in this case, I believe, for this man to go on and say he's a woman. And of course, the warnings. I think there's a lot more that can happen with warnings and to really explain to users what's going on these websites and how these predators are using websites to fool victims and to trap them into these kinds of situations.
So you're talking about more than just boilerplate warnings on the opening screen of the website. You're talking about some proactive things that they should do to ensure that people are who they represent themselves to be.
Right. I believe there should be things done to verify the identities of members, number one. And then number two, with regard to the warning, it shouldn't just be a little thing you can click on if you want to see a warning. It should be something, when you become a member, that pops up and goes through. These are the dangers, and this is what you need to be aware of, and this is how you protect yourself. Now, after this happened, there has been some additional warnings, which we allege should have been there before, but those are a start anyways.
How many women do you think?
Well, I don't know. I'm concerned that there's dozens. I think it's very possible that it goes into the dozens. I know in the indictment there is another four women in these videos. I don't know if they're all drugged, but there's I think they made about 12 or 13 videos, and each video has a number of women in them. So I don't know the numbers, but...
Jeff, when we ask her, according to the lawsuit, it says that she's suffering from mental suffering, shame, and humiliation. Can she tell us about that?
Yeah, can you touch on that?
Yes, I have a very young son, and I did get affected heavily and humiliated because people will come up to me and recognize me from this video, which that is not my lifestyle or any way that I would do something like that. I have a career, and this is very hurtful to me. Mentally, I have to be able to have a relationship with anyone, because I'm afraid of the effects, or maybe they will recognize me, or that's why they're trying to date me. I mean, it's really hard having to go through something like this.
Okay. Alrighty.
I've talked of physical, the psychological help. I had to, because living with this for years without telling anybody about it is very hard, because it's shameful. And it makes you feel very, ashamed of yourself for what happened to you. And you have to realize that you're a victim.
Right. And what she's talking about is really important. I mean, hopefully a takeaway from this is for other victims out there is not to suffer in silence, to come forward and get help. You're not alone. And staying silent about something like this is really worse for you. And to get help. And they're victims and they deserve to be helped. So, okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Just quickly, Mr. Herman, Callum.